you have ever owned a pet? Yeah, many people do. Pets are companions that can vary from person to person based on who they are and help people just have a nice companion throughout their life. So most people around the world and even in this classroom have all had pets at some point in their life or know someone who's had a pet and have an interaction with an animal. But most people don't know where these the effects of just getting an animal if they want to get a pet. Today I'm going to talk to you about I'm going to talk to you about why adopting a pet is better than buying a pet. And I've done a lot of research into this topic, which makes me credible to talk about it, and I've also have multiple adopted pets myself. So first I'm going to explain why animal shelters are good, then the effects of adopting versus buying a pet, and then how someone can help. So now that I've introduced this topic, I'm going to proceed to my first main point, which is why animal shelters are good. Nice animal companion. So an animal shelter is a place where stray animals are kept and are sometimes are left by their owners, which is kind of sad. So most shelters actually have funding problems and need a lot of funding to require the constant upkeep that they need to take care of all the animals. So according to PetMD.com, a common misconception among pet adopters, as well as the community at large, is that animal shelters are funded by taxpayer dollars and adoption fees. Most of these fees go to paying for food, water, kennel, anything needed to provide for the animals inside, and most of the labor they need for volunteers. Due to a limited budget, shelters have to euthanize any animals that don't get adopted because they don't have the space to add any more into their kennels. And according to AFPCA.org, each year approximately 1.5 million shelter animals are euthanized. So this encourages more people, should encourage more people to adopt because this will create more room inside of shelters which can let them add more animals in and on all save more lives for, save more animal lives. Now that I talked about animal shelters, I want to compare the effects of adopting an animal versus buying one. So there are many reasons to a person can choose for buying an animal or adopting one, such as like, convenience, or if they want a certain breed, like dog or cat. But most people don't know that there are lingering effects that happen after you do such a purchase or a transaction. So in a shelter, most animals were strays and left there and are looking for a decent home. According, again, ASPCA.org, there's about 6.5 million strays that are entered into shelters every year. So, adopting an animal helps, like I said before, create more room to let more animals come in and help save their lives by like, giving them a home and giving them a chance to be able to have a home to go to. So while adopting from a shelter is very helpful, most stores, has a bad effect on animals. So most stores, like we'll use dogs for an instance, get dogs from a place called Puppy Mill. These places lock up dogs in cages just to breed repeatedly and repeatedly so they can get cash. Like that. According to HumaneSociety.org, Puppy Mills contribute to pet overpopulation and cause countless dogs lifetimes of suffering in squalid white wire cages. And these dogs often live in these cages with little to no human interaction throughout their whole lifespan and are subject to multiple like infections or inbreeding that is not humane for a dog. So buying from a place, buying from a store kind of supports these mills, and that's why in this instant adopting is a lot better than actually buying. Nowadays more stores are some of them are converting to trying to get dogs from shelters as well to help the shelters out and prevent puppy mills from existing. And these mills aren't subject only to dogs. There's other animals as well, such as like kitten mills, which imagine the same thing but with a cat. So now that I explained the effects of acquiring an animal in a shelter versus a store, I'm gonna talk about how most people can help. So there are many ways to help out these animals or shelters to help provide an animal a nice, comfortable life. And the easiest way to do it is just to volunteer. So like I said earlier, most shelters don't have the funding to be able to hire professional people or a lot of people to take care of the dogs, like feed them, walk them, clean out their kennels, or same thing with cats or bunnies. And so volunteering at a simple shelter can help just give a better life for the dogs and help a person themselves, because you're going to interact with a lot of animals, and that's soothing to a lot of people, just being able to spend a day with dogs. And then another way to help out is simply adopting an animal as well, because adopting an animal helps the shelters gain money to help pay for the dogs, like food and like space, and also pay for like the shelters to be able to actually be there, and continue the cycle of letting them get more dogs in and more dogs out, which prevents dogs from being euthanized. According to PETA.org, if you plan on adopting a dog, adopting an animal, it's better to actually adopt two because it gives an animal a companion. Because most animals need companionship and some suffer if they're alone. So now that I've talked about how people can help, I'm going to wrap up this speech. So first I'll explain why animal shelters are good, and then the effect of adopting versus buying, and then how you can help. And I've told you how adopting an animal is way better than buying. So now, Andrew's just saying that if you're ever looking to buy or go get an animal, adopting is a much better choice than buying, because in turn you will save another animal's life.